a lot of debate now whether or not the death pictures of Osama bin Laden should be made public. Here is what the president told 60 Minutes and Steve Croft about why he will not release those pictures.
There is no doubt that we killed Osama bin Laden. It is important for us to make sure that very graphic photos of somebody who was shot in the head are not floating around as an incitement to additional violence, as a propaganda tool. That's not who we are.
So the decision has been made, but my next guest has seen the photos. Congressman Mike Rogers, he's chairman of the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence. And sir, good morning to you. First of all,
Bill,
do you agree with this decision or not?
I did, and I called prior to the president's decision that we should not release the photo or photos. It's a gruesome shot. It's a head wound. Anyone seen a crime scene photo, and there's lots of those out there, it's gruesome to look at. And my point was this.
Yeah, well, what concerns you or what worries you about it going public?
Absolutely. You know, I talked to a soldier yesterday, and I think this exemplifies the point, who was in Iraq right during the Abu Ghraib photo release. And right leading up to it, their unit was told, get extra medical kits, double your patrols, and be ready for more violence. And sure enough, when all that stuff got out in the public, there was more violence. There was a clear spike in violence to those soldiers. And my argument is this.
So you're worried about blowback.
Well, listen, I'm worried about our soldiers who are in combat zones where we know we have a good history that releasing a photo like this will increase violence. And if it costs one soldier's life, it's not worth it. You know, the Taliban isn't going to believe us no matter what we tell them. And my argument is we have the family saying, yes, he's dead. We have DNA evidence. We have other evidence as well. I think more is probably going to come out about Osama bin Laden's death. And we have all of that, and we have to get on with the fight on the war on terror. Releasing the photo doesn't get us anything. I mean, there's a lot of people who are
okay,
curious.
Now, you know.
That's not going to do anything.
Right, you know that there have been, there was at least one photo that's circulating on the internet. And it's not legitimate. It's a fake.
Yeah.
Now, the picture you saw, was it a fake? Was it doctored? Because some other members of Congress have already been duped.
No, this was a photo. I happened to be at the agency on Monday for other business and saw the photo in the custody of the CIA. No, it was the legitimate photo. And here's the point. You put that out, what are people going to say, Bill? They're going to say, that's a fake. It's a dupe. He's not really dead. You got to do more. You have to prove more. And so we incite violence, and we don't really close that chapter. Makes no sense to me. To the conspiratorialists, who, by the way, aren't going to be changed. These are the same kind of conspiracy theorists who believe that George Bush had something to do with 9/11. You're never going to ever satisfy that segment of not only our population, but you're never going to convince the Taliban either. So let's get on with the rest of the proof so rational people can see it and agree with it. And then get on with the war on terror. It's not over. Osama bin Laden is dead, but the war on terror is not over.
One more question on that, though.
Sure.
Do you think that this photo will only be released eventually, and it's only a question of time?
I'm not sure of that. It's in pretty tight control and custody. I wouldn't release it any time until, maybe future generations. Maybe not even then. It's a gruesome crime photo. And remember, here's the question you have to ask, Bill. Is it worth the life of one U.S. soldier or Marine to release this photo? If violence spikes up and it takes one life that might not have had to happen, is it worth it? Absolutely not. It's not worth it. We have other proof. Rational people should get on board with this, and let's move on and allow our soldiers to do what they do best and come home safely.
Amen to that. And we applaud them again. 10 years down
Thanks.
The road, what a sacrifice they have all made. Mike Rogers,
yeah,
thank
sure
you for
have.
Your time on Capitol Hill.
Hey.